hoping for better. Likewise, the Iranians used to dominating their continental competitions, but making steps in the right direction to get in amongst the global elite. Andrea Gianni, Germany's coach, fabulous career as a player with the Italian national squad, an incredible 27 medals in a 13-year international career for Italy as a middle blocker. Iran as well, guided by an expert who's come in from the outside, Igor Kolarković, the legendary Montenegrin coach who had 8 years in charge of Serbia, led that nation to world championship podiums. Wily old head, the 53-year-old, 2 years in the job now for Kolarković. He actually took over from Raul Lozano, who moved on to take over at China. So, a meeting of old friends here in Jiangmen. At that bronze in the World Grand Champions Cup 2017, Iran's first international medal. So Iran will be full of confidence here. And looking to round off the China leg of VNL 2019 with a sweep of victories. The old order is quaking. The newcomers, like Iran, are coming and they are hunting down the European heavyweights, the more established nations. Starting 6-4, Germany. Hirsch starts on the opposite side. Boma and Reichert in from the start as well. So it's a front-loaded starting six here from Germany. Majerad at opposite, Fayazzi on wing side. That's the same starting six that began the previous match, the straight sets victory over China. Match day three here in Jiangmen. Germany take on Iran. Well, a ripping serve straight off the bat, which is a service fault. So, aggressive start from Jan Zimmermann. Iran side out straight away. Eliskar Mosherat, out of the squad. That World Youth Championship a couple of years ago in the Czech Republic. Gafor and Fayazzi pushes long. Senger is the German libero. Punch down from Sayed. 2-0 for Iran. Mosherat will serve again. Catches the tape and back down Iranian side of the net. So Germany ninth in the VNL last year. Fifth in the World League back in 2012. That's been their best outcome in terms of the annual gathering of the top volleyball nations. It was World League up until last year, then the reconfiguration of the Big Summer Jamboree. Sees the VNL launched. Hirsch with the ace. Big success for Germany recently. The European Championship 2 years ago. They reached the final, beaten in five sets by the Russians. Hirsch was part of that team. His service is rocking Iran back currently. Aruf Lacrani with the set. Fayazzi there. Germany joust and do get it. Two. Opening set, Simon Hirsch will serve. 7 points in the first match here in Jiangmen, 14 in the second. Zenger set goes to wing side, Sossenheimer up. Has casual score off the blocking hands to make it 5-2. From Ulm, five times a German youth champion. His service game here is anchoring Germany. Fayazzi and the block again, working from the word go here today. 6-2 now. They're on a roll, Germany. Zimmermann pushes the set there into the path of Sossenheimer. In-out challenge here from Iran. They immediately looked across to the coaching setup, who of course are the ones that have to officially lodge the challenge. Out, clearly. Yeah, just throwing a bit of a spanner into the German works there, Kolarkovic. Just trying to upset the flow as much as anything with that challenge and the couple of minutes delay that is required to sort it out. Gafford. And again, Gafford very flat there. Zenger on the pickup. Sossenheimer serves. Fayazzi. Well, his service so far here in Jiangmen been more than reliable. Goes for all aspects of his game. That's a monster block. Superb execution and timing of the jump. And then the steering of the arms to guide the shot as well. That's a special moment for Maruf Lacrani. On service once more. Down the throat of Zenger, and that's a nice touch, a caress from Bremer to get the ball down on the floor. Fayazzi serving. Off the hands and away for a German point, 7-6. Hirsch was the decoy. Delivery of the shot from Riker. 19-year-old Bremer with that serve. Marufa Crani, smooth as silk. The transition there, the set up for Zayed, who finishes it. Mohamed Mousavi Zayed now back at the service line for Iran. First point of the day. Double figures against the Chinese yesterday, finished on 9, say it. Ripping serve, ace. Just basically unreturnable. Service and the attack points working for Zayed and Iran here. 8-7 in a really competitive opening set. Last year's 3-2 win for the Iranians in Tehran was the first time a world-level major competition match between these two nations had not been picked up in straight sets. An indication right there, as if it were needed, that Iran are a serious outfit these days. Eight, seven, Zayed on serve. Rykert receives it, tries to finish. Fayazi back into play, that's Marouf Lakrani with the set. And Gafour back over that 3-metre line without the purchase or the back lift, really, to swing through the shoulder. Which enabled Germany to block back for 8 now. All square. Disappointing service from Jan Zimmermann. Marouf. The skipper wastes the service. Moritz Reicher, the wing spiker from Berlin, recycling volleys now to serve. Well, that's the fifth error that has contributed now to Iran's score. Half of Iran's points coming from German mistakes. Badipour at least plays safe with that service. Hirsch repelled. Marouf Lakrani gives it to Fayazi. Scoring off the block. That was fabulous, wasn't it, Badipour getting low to pick that shot up from Hirsch, because the German really gave it the hammer there. So Badipour serves now. He was a Polish champion with the Belkatel in 2018. Quick transition that allows Bomer, the man they call the Tower, to rise tall. With Olympiakos now, the experienced Marcus Bomer. So much pace on that serve. Too much, really. 12-10 Iran, opening set. Elskar Mocharad now. Good game time for Mocharad here in China. Well, Germany had been looking for that quick AB set. Bremer involved. Jayajani has called the timeout here. Just as the Iranian lead pushes out to three.
How many spikes? How many? It's a spike. How many spikes? One. How many? One. Yes.
Interesting challenge that Tajani took on, going to manage Germany, taking over from Vital Einen. Tough act to follow, the charismatic Belgian Einen, who departed in 2017. Germany trailing here in the first set. Elskar Mocharad continuing on serve for Iran. Land anything at the moment, Germany. Sossenheimer with a chance, wing side. Now it's Hirsch who goes over the top. Iran tried to dig out, but can't get there in time to prevent the floor touch. Sky's chop. Hirsch waiting for the blockers to commit, and then dabbing the shot over. Hirsch serves. Sayed on the pickup. Ah, good aggressive defense that from Sayed. You can see him make that reception and step forward to give Maruf Lakrani the option. But Iran skipper went behind him to Gafur. Points for the Jangmen there, Gafur. It's not going to be 41 though. Germany side out then. Next to serve in the rotation is David Sossenheimer from MKS Beijing in Poland. Badipur receives. Maruf Lakrani setting forth Fayazi. Reliable supply lines there for Iran. 2 points for the match for Fayazi. Oh, that's a great save, and you perhaps think that Ibadipour might have set off a little bit earlier to make that pickup. So that was brilliant defense to begin with. Then you need a front court player to bail you out. Fayazi adding to his repertoire and his reputation. Piece of defending, but in vain for Iran. Bremer with that spinning serve. Ibadipour, wing side, cracks that spike cross court. Well played, Milan Ibadipour there. That's his first point of the match. Iran leads 16-13. And take us into the first technical timeout. Players for Iran have 3 points. Fayazi and the man you're looking at there, Mohammed Mousavi Sayed. Experienced middle blocker. First choice. Well, we're seeing Masharad being blended into the side alongside Sayed here in China. And they are going to try out more combinations. Shafi'i, the experienced 16, is perhaps the first choice partner of Sayed there in the middle. All about trying different combinations, working things out over the course of the VNL Intercontinental Round. From the long list of 25, you can choose 14 names for each pre-match leg. Danger of Iranians getting in each other's way there. Timmerman. Marouf with the set. Gafour. Just had the one blocker to elude there, Amir Gafour. Germany slow to organise defensively. Captain serves, Marouf Lakrani. There's the set. And the shot got a touch off the block on its downward kick there from Tobias Crick. Moritz Reichert serves now, already a German Cup winner, German champion with the Berlin recycling volleys. Marouf Lakrani, again, tidy set in for Fayazi, but he pushes that pipe finish. And they round block it back, but it's out, so it'd be a German point. 1 point set now. Make hay with the overpass there, Iran. Reichert will continue on serve. Nope. The 2 point buffer is established. Once more for Iran. Badipour, a little too long with his service. One of the players that has stepped outside his own borders for experience in top-level European club volleyball with Belkatel. And the two other players as well are in Italy with their clubs. Montesa Sharifi. Mohamed Manavinejad, the opposite, who hasn't been used here in Jiangmen. They play in Italy with the Blue Volley Verona. There seems to be just enough room down the line for Hirsch to get the ball down on the floor there for Germany. Match is level. As well.
side.
Both sides have a single timeout remaining in this set, and that's useful because there will be further tweakings required, surely. It's 18-all. Last time we were level in this set was back at nines. And importantly, it's Germany just with a little bit of wind in their sails here. Because Iran have been leading, not by much, by two. But Germany haven't let them out of sight. Crucially now, it's all square. And with a chance now to get into the lead, Germany. Iran blocking, though. Sossenheimer. No. They go to the other side with the set there for Hirsch, using the opposite. Well, the signal initially was that it was a German point, so... Yeah, block touch has been... Well, block touch was the original decision, meaning that Germany had the point, which Igor Kolarkovic, Iran's coach, is now challenging. He doesn't think there was one. That would render it a clean out. I think the point would be Iran's and not Germany's. Through the arms. No touch there, is there? He was right to challenge Kolarkovic. So the ball will be transferred to the opposite service line. Ali Shafiei. Well, that time a clear touch off the block from that same side for the shot from Hirsch. Linus Weber now, the young opposite, just 19 years of age, comes in from Berlin Recycling Volleys. The leading club that contributes to this German selection. So Zimmermann, the setter, drops out. It's Hirsch's turn in the rotation for service. No sooner do they get level again. They get Iran back. Another single point. The young novice, Thomas Kossian-Falken back. Sossenheimer gets the ball over the top. That's a great save there by Fayazi. Scrambling in, but couldn't control it. 20-all. Sossenheimer's serve. Good blocking from Germany. The height there, very important. Behind the block from Thomas Krick. Krick is 2 meters 11. Tallest member of the German squad. Super block. Germany lead around 21-20 here in the first set. Not for long. Error now. 12th German error, that is. 21 all. Fayazzi. Real pace on the serve again. Zenga picked it up. Gafur and then Hazrapur. And then Milad Ibaripur finishes it. Iran were in control in that rally. And this is the last timeout being used. Iran have used there too. Resume after the timeout with Fayazi serving for Iran. What a serve as well. Top spin on that, fizzing it over the tape, and pretty much impossible to defend or return. How on earth can you control a reception when the service is delivered with such velocity and speed? Germany are challenging this. So, footfall over the service line. Hopeful, wasn't it? Certainly no danger there that even the slightest hint of toenail flip that paint. Just a brilliant serve from Fayazi. Take two, question mark. Well, he goes down the line that time. They had a defender diving across. Oh, talk about mixing it up. A completely different approach to that service from Paria Fayazi. It looks like it's going to be an in-out call here. Because he's gone to the opposite side. He's gone to the opposite line. Said that that's the side our chair referee is sitting. The original call that it was out was out. Well, no need for Poya Yali for the time being. Captain back in. Well, the error allows Iran up to set point. Can't see it, do it. Just that moment when calm is needed. A set point, the noise of the crowd, expectation and the desire to wrap it up, but still got to concentrate on the basics and couldn't quite do it there. So German side out, Jan Zimmermann Still on set point here, Iran. But Germany could save another. They're in charge of this rally. And Zimmermann, Rijker, scores off the block. And we're at 24 all now. Well played, Germany. Saving two set points. Maruf Lakrani gets the set high. Iran improvising their defence there. Zimmermann, touchdown, which was the right shot. How on earth did Iran pick that up? Thought that ball was down on the floor. Rijkaard sets now, then tries the tap again. They've kept it live. Rijkaard, third touch in the rally. Loose ball, thumped home by Hirsch. And it's Germany who just turned this around. Back on serve. And enjoying a set point of their own now. Oh, Rijkaard with three opportunities on the wing to ground it. That was perhaps the best of them. The block work, but then Hazrapur dug it up. All to no avail, ultimately. Because it's a German point. A German service. And a German set point here. Vanipour through the block. Germany unable to deal with that. Lakrani serving for Iran. That's her. She buries that right in the face of Maruf Lakrani. That's the way to make sure. So now Germany have their second set point. Rijkaard's serve catches the tape. Straight back at you. Iran now making it 26 apiece at the end of this first set. ...25-year-old Milad Ibadipour to serve. Set comes over the head. Hirsch can't get power. Bajarczy. Block back again. They go for the pipe finish. And it's a miscued reception that allows Iran into another set point here. Just sense when the attacking is a little bit more controlled. Stands the Iranians in better stead. Ibadipour. Still can't get the touch that wins this set. They'd rather have Vaxpola serving than Boma. Slick transition again. Yet another set point for Iran. just off the service reception. That is how to turn defence into attack. Sottenheimer, who wants to win this set? Holding serves the key, 28 all. So Hirsch now serving for Germany. Last year's VNL top scorer for the Mannschaft. Where's he going to aim it? Ah, he was going for power off the jump serve. That high stakes formula. Great serve from Gafford under pressure like that. Sossenheimer to Zimmermann, over pass, Iran should kill this, indeed they do. 30-28, they made very heavy weather of getting through the finishing tape at the end of that set, but Iran are there, and after their terrific form in Jiangmen so far, they've taken the opening set too here against the Germans, saving the best for last almost. And the spike finish down the line from Amir Gafour, 30-28. Iran win a marathon first set. A lot of mistakes then in that first set on both sides of the net. Iran won't necessarily worry about where the points came from as long as they've got sufficient. They did hold their nerve at the end of that set. So spike contact points, the setting of Saeed Marouf-Lakrani as reliable as ever. Out to wing sides. Slightly edges it at the moment. But the contribution of points has come from all areas for Iran. Ibadipour with four, Fayazi with four, Gafour with three, Sayed with three. A hard-working team and a dangerous team as well. And it is perhaps significant that the victory for Iran in Tehran in last year's VNL, the 3-2, was the first time a world-level match between these two nations had gone the distance. It's just another reminder here in Jiangmen, China, that Iran are on the march. This is an important staging post along the route to Tokyo 2020. That'll come around quickly, just over a year away now. Signs are very good for Iran. Great rally here at the start of the second set. That's not something you see from the Iranians too much. Hesitancy and a kind of sort of an issue with communication. Case really of everyone leaving the pickup to everyone else. We know what happens when that situation is present. No one picks it up. Boma. Corking serve. That's what caught back on his heels. And Riker on the pickup. Shot from Sossenheimer comes back. Pike finish finally. Iran have picked that up as well. It's a decent strike there from Hirsch, and then Gafoor hits it. Block touch. Two solid rallies at the start of set two here. We've seen a yellow card brandished. The whistle goes straight from the service line there. They're all very light-hearted. I'm pretty sure the yellow card actually was shown in the direction of Simon Hirsch, the German opposite. Perhaps a refereeing team understand German better than a lot of the squad would give them credit for. Neither side able to really settle at the start of this second set. One or two stoppages, a bit of dialogue with the referees. Two very good rallies, actually, but no flow yet to speak of. Germany, remember, are in recovery mode. They're digging in here in the group. Because Jiangmen China has been all about Iran. Hirsch on service. That's an ace. Just a little moment like that could bring all that momentum back behind Germany. Fabulous execution of the service there from Simon Hirsch. 3-1 here. Decides not to go with power on the follow-up serve. Another flatter delivery that time, and Crick just jabbing the hand over. Nice and smooth this. Tobias Crick, 2 meters 11. Young hope. Hirsch really asking questions again with his service. Maruf Lakrani with the set, and then Fayazi comes in. That combination using Fayazi wing side. We've not seen much of it yet in this match from Iran. Gafford. 4-2 for Germany is the score. It was that at the beginning of the first set too. Iran ended up winning that, so long way to go here. Pushed out to 5-2 now, Germany. Rolling serve there from Sossenheimer, but it was under hit. Maria Fayati now serving in the rotation for Iran. They trail by two. It's 5-3 Germany here in the second set. Five-three becomes 6-3. Spiker up and down. Well played there, Ribadipour. And we hear the familiar super spike music around the arena. 101.3 kilometres an hour, that's a missile. Off the service of Sayed. Ball work to her, she does what he does best. Seven-four now here for Germany in the second set. Jan Zimmermann of Grensaard Massic in Belgium on the serve there, got a nice sprinkling of international club experience in the German ranks. Riker stayed home with Berlin recycling volleys. But the players here who play over the border in Italy, in Poland, with Christian Fromm with Vegiel. Now Germany hitting a stride now at 8-5. Boma, one of the big players here in Jiangmen. Pushing the ball nicely down, smoothly down. Lead of three. First technical timeout of set two then. Steven Hirsch, Germany's leading point scorer in the defeat to Italy. More than 12 in their five-set win against China in the opening match. Nine points today for Simon Hirsch. It's five more than the nearest challenger in the German team. Franz Reichert, Marcus Boma. Bank 4 points apiece so far today. Won the European Games gold medal in Baku in 2015. Marcus Boehm, as well as being part of the silver medal Euro squad in 2017. Maruf Lakrani over the headset to Ivanipour. Shot comes through the blocker. Balipour serves for Iran. The Iranians are able to defend that, and a quite brilliant finish. Amir Ghafour. Stretched out defence, but the quality of this set there into the path of Amir Ghafour, and he runs onto that like a hero. Pushed into the corner as well, couldn't have placed it better. So much spin on the serve again from Ibadipour, blocked back into the corner. Third touch has to come over, and is a bit of an overpass there from Riker. So that's left to Shafiei to shovel it home. Iran a level at 8-all here in the second set. They've just upped their level now. Two very good serves back to back from Ibadipour. Make that three. Hirsch. Spin, but no power on the shot. Paiazzi with a chance, block back. Iran, what a great run. Germany have hit the buffers here. They need to stop the service of Milan Ibadipour. On another day, of course, that bounces back into play. Not there, though. So four in a row for Iran. Germany digging in, winning that point Oakley through Simon Hirsch. 9-9 here. To the net and over. Oh, what a save by Marouf Lakrani! And impudently, cheekily, Iran take that point. Credit the captain. Marouf Lakrani's pickup. Germany just didn't anticipate it, didn't it? Did they? They didn't anticipate the rally continuing. Zimmermann nor Sossenheim has set out early enough to make the dig. Ali Shafiei to serve. Zayed with the tip. Somebody needs to take control here. Brilliant defensive station there, taken up by Ibadipour. Went deep beyond the baseline for the pickup. Now Hirsch goes for power. Flat back into play by Zayed brilliantly again. And Germany win that joust. Eventually they get the point scored off the block of Maria Fayazzi. That's stopped a real bad rot for Germany. Conceded 5 points in a run there. 5 points in a row. Just now getting through that block though. Hirsch on serve at 10-10. Zayed sees the ball drop out. Marty steers that expertly. Different shot required going cross-court like that, because you haven't got the room to work with. You have to get the ball down quicker as well, which Fayazi managed there. His eighth point of the match. It's allowing Amit Gafur to serve, but straight into the net. Maruf Lakrani again teasing and going opposite side with a set. Bump tied by Sossenheimer, then Hirsch. The Iranians read that tip. Two blockers there pushing out Fayazi. They've wised up to the threat, it seems. Then Maruf Lakrani gets across the block. He's held out by Mohamed Zayed, and that's a monster block, bringing it to 12-12 here in the second set. Look at the way Sayed dives across, angles the arms in order to steer the block. That is fabulous defending. Kurt there, block took the sting out of the shot, enabled the libero Hazratpour to bump it up, and then Gafur gets ahead of himself, trying to crash that spike over in the opposite position. Tobias Crick with a serve. Sends it over flat as well. Ivanipour goes down the line and misses. There's a gap of two now for Germany. That constitutes clear daylight. So tight has this match been. Crick playing it very safe from the service line. Zayed gets that touch over. Germany weren't getting that back. So 14-13 here. Sensationally. Occasionally, everything falls into place. Contact point, speed, and dip. Gone down the line again, not that time. Well, the arm went up, awarding the point to Germany, so it's been called out. So close. Yeah. Not at all surprised to see a challenge put in here. So the initial call was out, thus awarding the point to Germany. Kolarčević is challenging it. It really would be something if this is overruled, and indeed the serve was in, because that means back-to-back aces for Mohamed Mousavi Sayed in more or less the same spot on the court as well. We wait and wonder, and it's clipped the paint. It was in. Brilliant service. Brilliant service again from Mohamed Mousavi Sayed. Oh, back-to-back aces. He's just too hot to handle at the moment. Not going to get three in a row, is he? Yes, he is! Not quite. Great pickup there. Germany on the improvised defence. Doesn't matter in the long run because Iran just bundled the point anyway. But I thought he was going to get his hat-trick there. ...16-14 then. And a marvellous turnaround by Iran in the course of this second set. So far today for Maria Fayazzi, but it's this player's all-round game. Very much part of the squad. An obvious sense of the togetherness of this Iranian party. They work hard for each other. Last forever. Serving run of Sayed. Monster block for Germany. That ties it up at 16 all. When you've got a man in there whose nickname is the Tower. Zimmermann's serve. Yeah, Germany able to block because that second touch set was a little bit difficult for Gafur to execute. Gafur turns into the setter there for Ibaripour, who plays a very clever shot, pitching it right down, almost on the three-metre line. But it's Germany looking to benefit from the free ball here. And Hirsch will score off the block. Good rally, that. It's very, very finely balanced now, this second set between Germany and Iran. Just having to work for every point, Germany. Well, the German party will fly off to Canada for the next round of matches in the Volleyball Nations League. Relatively shorter trip that Iran when they depart China. So to Tokyo for their next three matches in the VNL. Lakrani serve there. Ibaripour went high with the shot. Playing the percentages there because there's always the chance of an obvious block touch point there for Iran. Even if he wasn't able to get the ball on the floor. Yeah, just rolling it off the fingernails almost of Seaman Hirsch. The height of backspooler required here. Not with the end product on the spike. He said they transferred it to Reichert, but Hirsch over the top of the net, blocking down. Well played. Hirsch didn't take his eye off the ball for a split second there. Ably assisted by backspooler and shot alongside. Moritz Reichert serves. Overpass. Good serve that by Reichert. So this should be Germany's. Indeed it is. Side could establish a clear lead at this point in the previous set. And we're getting very near the stage where holding serve is what it will be all about. Right on cue, Reichert fails to do exactly that. Shot. David Sossenheimer getting up very high, but look at the angle on the downwards of the spike there. He hits that so shallow. Backspooler of spaces to lose, just can't keep that pressure on. Can't keep the hand round the throat. Back with Iran now on serve. Shafiei received by Reichert. Running around for the finish was Sossenheimer. Hirsch blocking it back. Gafford hits it very flat. Free ball comes up and then he's smashed down in turn by Zayed. Big player for Iran in this second set, Mohammed Zayed. Well, credit the dig. But really not much use if there's no one there. Middle blocking at the net to then snuff out the threat of the free ball. Now between this Iranian side and the ones that have represented the country at previous World Leagues and last year's VNL and previous World Champs is the sort of lack of respect that they're giving the opposition, the natural lack of respect that they would always, I suppose, have offered up to European heavyweight opposition down the years. But Iran now feel they belong here at this top table. Hirsch, ever reliable, the opposite there. Just fizzing over a cross-court shot. Leveling up the set again at 21-all. Rich gives up the advantage. They work so hard to slow the Iranians down. No sooner is that achieved than they give them a nudge again. That a timeout has been requested here, but it may have been requested just a little too late before the resumption of play. Sent again, maybe a problem for the Germans. Well, they can't turn the screw at 22-21. So we're level again as Gafford nets the service. Hearing that the yellow card was shown to the entire German team. David Sossenheimer on service. Into the net. We see this so, so often. It's a real syndrome at the end of the volleyball set, with the scores as close as they are, and service becomes ever more important. With that comes the pressure. Still have a timeout remaining. So Andrea Gianni has used his last of the set here. Germany just 2 points away from going 2 sets to love down. Fayazi, the player from Shadami Umiya, 1m94 wing spiker. Player of the round, I would argue, for Iran here in Jiangmen, China. Riker, one back and out, 23 all. Same old story. First set went out to 30-28. Surprised if it's that kind of number again before one of these two teams gets 2 points clear. They need him to set. Maruf Lakrani does precisely that for Ibadipour, but they don't win the point there, Iran. Reichert with the overpass. Oh, Syed. Rather missed his connection there, so they leave it to Ibadipour. Back come Germany with Reichert, blocked back and out, and it's a German set point. Just all about where the block was going to land there. Well, he's cleverly played that. Almost tried to angle it down the line. Got the block touch off. Fingertips of Maruf. Now, had he gone cross-court there and the block had worked, and I'm pretty sure we would have seen the ball coming over the net, dropping back into play. Just a clever angle of the shot there to work the point off the block. But holding service is a challenge all of its own. One that Germany will look to master now. Kosian, the young setter, on serve. No, Iran not only defend it, but translate into Zayed's finish. Well, he's done this plenty today, Zayed. He's been a real weapon. 24 all. Thanks to Zayed's ninth point of the match for Iran. Same player serves, but it's long. Germany have set point number two. That's the tip. The Germany have defended it. They've given themselves a chance to win the set now. Hirsch drops it back. Two-handed push down, and that's Maruf Lograni, the wily old head, coming in to just find the floor. It was pretty much a loose ball, free ball. Iran were in control for the moment that tip was picked up. Two-handed overpass. Maruf Lograni here to kill it. Five all. Hirsch goes on the diagonal. Set point number three for Germany. Reichert serving, good serve as well. Ivanipour beneath it, comes to Gafford, block back and out. And we go again. It is like the first set all over again. Milad Ivanipour on service. Set comes over the head, all sorts of miscommunication and hesitancy. Think clearly under pressure. That has to be the motif. Something Germany failed to do there. Still very well keeping your eye on the ball, but there has to be a sort of an extra awareness of the surroundings too. Three German set points have come and gone, slipped through their fingers. Iran now have their first set point. Vicious service. Great way to win it. Great way to win a set off an ace. But not there. So it's given out, but Iran are challenging. Not even close, I'm afraid. Now then, who has the nerve to win this set? Germany have passed up three set points. Iran have let one go. Germany service with Bax Polar, but the transition ends in the spike finish. Maruf Makrani again, the skipper, cushioning that set. Ali Shafiei coming in to give it the power that was needed. Taps over into the net, overpass, more by luck than judgment that came over, but the rally's still live. And then Hirsch goes long. Iran have taken the second set on their second set point. Germany, I think, will challenge, so we're not quite done yet. Clean out was given off the hit from Hirsch. Germany feel there was a block touch on the way through, then that would swing the point back to them. That was the reaction of Hirsch, standing right over it. So a little bit of theatre, a little bit of tension before we have confirmation of the way this match is heading. Are we going to reset? Or are Iran going to be able to win the set? Does it bend the fingernails back? There's no touch there, so it is a clean out. And Iran do win the set. 2-0 now for this impressive Iranian squad put together by Igor Kolarkovic for the Jiangmen leg. Oh, they're blitzing the opposition and are on course for a sweep of victories here. Germany find themselves 2-0 down. 30-28 in the first, 29-27 in the second. Iran back amongst the elites. Set three. Ibadipour, Fayazi, blocked back. Maruf Lakrani gives it to Fayazi, who finds the floor. Giving it real 100% power. Again, not required, not necessary there. Worked it to the side where there was only one blocker defending in Simon Hirsch. So down the ball came. Serving at 1-1 here. Rather low key service. Two-1 for Iran. How confident will they be approaching the rest of the Volleyball Nations League this season? Crick with a quick up and downer. 2-2. And in Tokyo, a week from now, Iran will play the host nation, naturally, plus Argentina and Brazil. And the matches with Argentina are going to be interesting because in Mendoza, corresponding pool being played over this opening weekend of the BNL for the men. Argentina out of the blocks with two wins from two. So two of the nations that want to lift their level in the BNL. They're very good chance of doing so towards the end of the international group phase. They will play next week in Mendoza. So it'll be interesting. And there'll be back-to-back home legs for the Iranians. Poland, Canada, Russia, Portugal, Australia and France, all the teams that will be going to Iran a little bit later in June. They finish in Bulgaria with matches against the Bulgarians, Serbia and the United States to Iran. Sayed has had an absolute blinder today. Middle of that blocking three. It was his touch there. And pushes Germany back again. 4-2 Iran in this third set. Serve working. And there's that sense of playing with just freedom, really. Two. Fayazi serves. Attempts Sossenheimer forward. Great dig out. Hasratpour with a bump. Maruf Lakrani with a set. Ibadipour will have a second go at it. Everything they're trying is working. Gap of four now. Thank you. Chamit Gafoor. Fayazi currently running at 11 points. Iran's top scorer on the day. That's a service fault, though, into his column. 6-3 here. Zayed is stepping back, rearranging his footwork, swinging through the shoulder. 7-3 around. Touch off the block, no getting that. Back over the net, really, from Iran. 7-4. Germany back on service. Jan Zimmermann here with a ball in hand. Player from Grignard Masek, the Belgian club. Deep dip in time. Technical timeout then in this third set. Iran first to 8. So Simon Hirsch, main source of German points. 17. Day here, 12 attacks, and the all-round nature of his game, demonstrated by 3 block points as well, plus 2 aces. So he's got the whole repertoire, the player who was top scorer for Germany in last year's VNL, with 183. Previous best tally here in China was 14. That was in a straight sets defeat to the Italians. Germany, by the way, have not lost consecutive world level major competition matches in straight sets since the 2014 World League. That's in danger of happening here. Four-year-old Ruben Schott. Hasrat Poor, nice and tight into the net. Very difficult to execute there on the flight of the dropping ball, the ball dropping off the set to then connect and get that downward angle. It's extremely difficult. Gafoor couldn't manage it there. Shot serves again. Gafoor goes long. Picked up by Sossenheimer, who then runs round. Scores off the block. Wild block touch back. But it bounced out. Oh! Gafford, wing side. German point then. Something upset the Iranians. Timeout's been called. Gaming not required. Or Sharifi. Or Manabi. All these experienced players with international medals over the last half decade or so. Coach Kolarčević's decision to kick them under mothballs. They'll go with a blend that he's put out here in Jiangmen, China. Fully vindicated the level of performance that we've seen. Oh! Iran a little bit unlucky off the block there. Germany have engaged concentration levels and got themselves back to 9-all. Lekrani with that set. Syed with a touch that came back at them. Cross-court and off the shoulder of the blocker. The bounce was good anyway. But this could be an attritional slog here in set three. Germany have been unable to successfully hold serve throughout this match. Fayazzi on reception there. That's Ibadipour. Two-handed throw over. Hirsch blocked down and in. Syed with a monster block. Again, diving the right way. Angle of the arms absolutely supreme. And a crucial bit of good luck, good fortune you need as well. Gafford serves, and it's pitched at the libero as well, Zenga. Quality of the reception, though, is what enabled Germany to control that rally.
Mm-hmm.
One step forward, two back, it seems, at present for Germany. Bayazi serving at 12-11. Set back, almost using the residual dropping power of it to set it dead weight. 13-12. Crick is only 20. His role model is Dirk Nowitzki, the German who went off to the NBA and had an amazing 20-year career over there with the Dallas Mavericks. He's got the height to compete. Service faults traded. Ambitious in or out challenge here. So the serve was called out. Correct me. Unsuccessful challenge. Executed by the captain, Maruf Lakhrani, always seems to bring the Iranians riches one way or another. That time, he just cushions it for Shafiei. Now serves himself, Maruf Lakhrani. Germany set it over their head. Hazratpour, acrobatic libero skills. Zimmermann. Zenga, and Iran have done enough. Maruf Lakhrani continuing on service here. No obvious advantage there, though, as Germany get back to level it at 15s. Has to be pressure on the receiver. Otherwise, it's a controlled reception of the serve. It's a controlled bump. And then the setter comes into play, and you can work your favourite attacking combination. The dilemma that Germany are now facing. But they've received it well, and that's worth its weight in gold, because the set is right for Gafur. 16-15. Iran with their noses in the lead. Two-time Asian Games gold medalist Milad Ibadipour, 9 attacks, 9 blocks today. attacks, 9 points. I beg your pardon. Not the Iranian leading scorer. That honour is with Mohamed Sayed, who has 12. Maria Fayazi running on 11 as well, with Gafour and Chapier on 7. But they just benefit, I think, from not having an obvious star, an obvious go-to opposite. They are a true collective, the Iranians. Five-year-old Milad Badipour from Urmia. He was there in 2017 in Japan when Iran won their first world-level medal, the bronze in the World Grand Champions Cup. Germany level up the set again at 16-all. Backspurler on serve, it's a useful one, pushed out wide, but they get it to the opposite, and Amir Gafour comes in to kill. Now Ruben Schott turns 25 next month, Schnubi, the Berlin Volleys player, that's very came through and became a star before moving to Gdansk. Linus Weber comes off, slots into the rotation as Zimmermann steps into the technical area. Weber, the young opposite, just 19. Oh, that caught the breeze. Way long. Kostian Falkenbach, the Slovakian-born player. Parents moved to Germany when Thomas was 3. Gafour. As well to clear the net. Real boom on the service there from Gafour. The reactions there from Sayed to not be deceived by the tip. Bayatsi crashes the shot against the blocker. Gap of 2, 19 plays 17 now, business end of the third set. Again, it's intelligent play because the shot is sort of angled back in the direction from whence it came, and he just uses that left flailing arm of Crick to take the point, to ensure that the point is scored. Amir Gafour plays his club volleyball in Italy with Monza. Kossia with that set seemed a little bit high and it allowed the Iranians to regroup and read the flight. Well, they're just opening the box of tricks and, well, pulling out a random selection. They've got the whole repertoire now, Iran. Fayazi, I tell you, he has the lot. He has the power and the poise.
four with an ace, and it ran off flying. 21-17. They're on their way to another straight sets win.
You just doff your cap to the quality of the service. Second ace of the day.
Second serve dropped as well. It was going in. Maruf Lakrani gives it to Syed, who makes sure. Not clean, doesn't need to be. But that's a measure of the understanding between Maruf Lakrani and whoever he finds himself alongside in the front row. They're pulled out to a lead of five now. Some of the momentum checked by Gafford's service fault. Sossenheimer on serve. Germany don't have the advantage for long. Maruf Lakrani gives it to Syed. They're coming in from backcourt to retrieve. This is the overpass. So a chance to get to 23 now for Iran. Hirsch with a good dig out, blocked back. That white-shirted wall over the top of the net for Iran. Maruf Lakrani will steer the second touchdown inside the sideline. A captain's touch there. Edges Iran closer. He's very selective about the moments that he drops a shot like that, Maruf Lakrani. You can't do it too often, because otherwise the opposition get wise to it. Well, that's the way to end a rally that measures almost 30 seconds. Just a brilliant shot. Speedy serve which clipped the tape. Germany back in control though, and have the point with Tobias Krick. Dreams, surely, did Igor Kolarkovic imagine that they would have a sweep of victories here in Changmen, China. On serve. Don't end it there with a cherry on top. But receiving now, this surely will be the moment for the Iranians, who have been most impressive in Changmen. Bumped up by Hazratpour. Overpass there from Gafford. Ruben shot blocked, he'll go again. Second shot was higher over the blockers. And they're going to watch that drop out to celebrate the victory. And Igor Kolarkovic's Iran team, since losing the opening set on the opening day to the Italians, have not looked back. They've won every set since. And that's included the four-set victory over Italy, and now in straight sets, the sweep of the Chinese hosts and Germany here. What a start to VNL 2019 by Iran. Proving to us that they belong at the elite level. And they will have back-to-back home legs as well a little bit later in this VNL Intercontinental round. So do they have a chance of making the cut this year? No one will want to face them. That's as sure as guaranteed. A real wake-up call for Italy and for Germany in particular here in Jiangmen. The Chinese probably had more realistic aims and expectations, but they will finish their campaign later against the Italians. That will be the final match of the pool here, and that will get underway in 2 hours from now. In the meantime, Iran will celebrate their 3 wins here in Jiangmen. Very impressive here against the Germans. 2 very tight opening sets that went to 30-28 and 29-27 before Iran smoothed their passage with the winning of set 3 here, 25-20.